Okay. Ignoring that minor annoying crash earlier, we're back. So, I think the save is before we talk to Rice.
All right, out with it. What's your game?
Game? What do you mean?
So we have to do this little speech bit again.
Up at a glance, but you're different. And it's bugging the heck out of me. You're not the military type. You're a loner. So I can't.
Seriously, he has a shovel on his chest.
You got what you wanted, so why don't you hit the road?
The Brotherhood might be the best chance I'll ever have to find my son.
Well, as far as reasons go, that's a pretty good one. Look, I'm gonna cut you some slack because Dance trusts you. But if you step out of line and put any of my brothers or sisters in danger, I'll make sure you regret it. So, ready for your assignment, hero?
Yeah, sure.
Ready.
Then listen up. Like it or not, one of our most important duties is to keep the Commonwealth clear of the trash. I'm talking about mutants, ghouls, synths. The abominations the damn eggheads caused when they started playing with their toys. This op is simple. I'm gonna send you to a target, and you're gonna terminate everything that calls it home. All the details you need are right here. Don't come back until the job's done.
Okay. Alright, so let's do a quick save here. And hopefully it won't crash when we leave this time. Free your mind.
No.
What if I don't want to free my mind? Okay. Excuse me. So this is actually pretty close, which is good, because it means that we can start obliterating everything in the face right away. No, because who doesn't like obliterating everything in the face? Oh, right, hold on. Sorry, I almost forgot. I gotta pause my stream because of the lag. We are taking rats, thank you for noticing. Alright. The sound of me murdering everything? Because, yeah, I totally hear that. Oh, is it inside the station? Okay.
Something's ghosting us.
Yeah, that makes sense. Down we go. College Square Station. Welcome back. I was gonna say, did I just set off something? And yeah, totally did.
Being followed.
Easy peasy. It's funny because he had a thing. Yeah. He had a paintbrush. Shut up. I don't know. Whatever. Leave me alone. It's kind of weird that Medics is suddenly purple for no reason, whatever. That one screw sticking off the front of that scope is driving you bonkers. I know, right? Trust me, it fucking annoys me too. It very much annoys me too. How do I get in there? Oh. There we go.
That's it.
Damn it. Okay. All right, removed a whole bunch of duds. Sorry, dude. I hate that I turn them on only to blow them up, but I turn them on only to blow them up. I don't really hate it. I just do it because, well, because why not? Hey, that's my experience. Jesus Christ, did that guy immolate himself? Oh, by the way.
Your attempted escape is only making things worse for you.
Sorry. Cleared the place out, apparently. College Square station key. Oh, shit.
Oh, you're dropping that. Are you daft?
No, it was an accident. Really cleared this place out? Journal scrap. Honestly, probably us. We live in a wasteland. It's not like we're bathing often. You know? Think about it. Come on, Kate. You're smarter than that. Yeah, but I like how it says that we cleared the place out. But there's still a bunch of enemies up here, man. Still a whole bunch of enemies up here. In fact, I dare say there's a lot of enemies still out here. Might be all of them. Might. I'm not sure. Yeah, good enough. It's gonna fuck out of Dodge. Can turn to rice and get our reward for murdering a whole bunch of zombies. Which I would have done anyway. Seriously, I'd have done it anyway, so getting a reward for it? Sign me the fuck up.
Clear?
Yep.
Affirmative.
That's what I like to hear. Here's what you're owed. Commonwealth is a big place in need of some serious exterminating. Take a breather if you need it. When you're ready, just say the word.
I mean, I finished the quest.
I'm not ready.
Right. I better not catch you screwing around when there's work to be done out there.
Where's Paladin Dance? Let's do some story mode quests. So, we're going to do Shadow of Steel. Because I don't feel like doing 5 of those. Not right now, at least. Maybe later.
Paladin Dance.
Are you ready to head up to the ship?
Why is it here?
Why did the Brotherhood send it here in the first place?
God damn it.
I'm not sure. But I think it might have something to do with the data on the Commonwealth my team gathered before it arrived. We call our ship the Pridwin. She's loaded with enough troops and supplies to mount a major offensive. If she's here, Elder Maxon's here. And that means we're going to war.
Who's Elder Maxon?
Maxon is the commander of this division of the Brotherhood of Steel. He's the model of what every Brotherhood soldier hopes to become. If we're going to war, I can promise you that he'll be leading the charge. That being said, you're about to get to know the Pridwin up close and personal. I've received orders that we're both to report to her immediately. Follow me up to the roof of the police station. We're going for a little ride.
Can Kate come? Can Kate come? I want Kate to come. She's my friend. She's my friend. Excuse me. weird. That was weird. It wouldn't let me use it. Strange.
Making like a bird, eh? Let's do it.
Nice! Kate gets the gun.
That mini gun in front of you is loaded and ready to fire. If you spot anything hostile during the flight, I suggest you put it to good use. Make sure you properly identify your targets before you start shooting. We don't want to have any mishaps and fire on the local.
And this is pretty cool, and also it's going to probably be really laggy.
The world looks different from up here, doesn't it? It never ceases to amaze me how drastically your perception of the battlefield changes from the air. We're going to need that edge when we take on the Institute. They've already proven that they're technologically superior, which means there's no telling what types of weapons they'll have in their arsenal. Hopefully, our air superiority and tactical know-how will make the difference. Now all we have to do is find them. And I'm betting that Elder Max will have a plan already in place by the time we arrive. I wish everyone down there believed in our cause, but they've been blinded by rumors and misinformation. They don't realize that the Brotherhood of Steel is the Commonwealth's last hope for survival. Every man, woman, and child below is in mortal danger. Matter of time before the enemy overwhelms the population. Cleansing the Commonwealth is our duty, and I will gladly spill my own blood if it ensures our victory.
Yeah, see, here comes the frame rate drops.
The Fridwin should be coming into view just ahead. He'll be meeting Lancer Captain Kells on the flight deck. Just stick close to me and answer all of his questions.
Holy shit. It's the blimp. It's a rigid airship. Don't call it a blimp. Yeah, we discovered the Boston Airport somehow. Ironic if it were flying over it. I'm gonna start gunning the shit out of it and blow our own propellers out. I mean, I feel like we're just flying in circles around it. Oh, I guess I could have just gone in third person for this. Alright, first things first. That's always the first thing you have to do when you're up here. Just, you know, just jump down.
Permission to come aboard, sir? Permission granted. Welcome back, Paladin. Allow me to be the first to congratulate you on a successful mission.
Is this our new recruit?
Yes, sir. I field promoted her to initiate, and I'd like to sponsor her entry into our rankings personally.
Yes, we've read your reports. You'll be pleased to know that Elder Maxon's approved your request and placed the recruit in your charge.
Thank you, sir. And my current orders?
You are to remain on the Fridwin and await further instructions.
Very good, sir. Ad victoriam, Captain.
Ad victoriam, Covenant.
Captain Kells?
So, you're the one Paladin Dance has taken under his wing. You don't look much like a soldier to me.
Then what's a soldier supposed to look like?
A soldier is supposed to be an efficient killing machine. Not a relic from the past playing catch-up with the rest of the world.
How do you know?
Dance hadn't stepped in and vouched for you. We wouldn't even be having this conversation. Accepting outsiders like yourself has proven disastrous in the past. I've read Paladin Dance's reports. He seems to think you'll make a fine addition to the Brotherhood. You might expect an endorsement like that to grant you a great deal of latitude with us. But let me make one thing clear. The Brotherhood of Steel has traveled to the Commonwealth with a specific goal in mind. As the captain of this vessel, I won't allow anyone to jeopardize our mission, no matter how valuable they think they are. Understood?
Absolutely.
Good. That's all for now.
I say, rolling my eyes.
Your orders are to proceed to the command deck for the address. After which, Elder Maxson wishes to have a word with you. If you have any questions, ask me now. Otherwise, you're dismissed.
Can you tell me anything about Elder Maxson?
Elder Maxson is the supreme commander of the Brotherhood. Without his tenacity and his vision, we'd still be a small group of complacent stragglers occupying the Citadel and the Capital Wasteland. In a mere
decade,
he's grown the Brotherhood of Steel into a major military force. He's an inspiration to us all. Is there anything else?
Yeah. Where can I get power armor?
Only knights are allowed to wear Brotherhood power armor. And you're no knight. Not yet.
Funny about
until
that.
Elder Maxson grants you that title, you'll have to make do with
so they are from the Capital Wasteland.
Else?
That's kind of bullshit. Like, it just makes...
What are my orders?
Your orders are to proceed to Elder Maxson's address, after which he wishes to speak with you. Anything else?
I don't have any questions.
Then I suggest you head over to the command deck immediately. Dismissed, initiate.
Rude. You didn't even say hi to Kate.
Welcome aboard. Elder Maxson is holding his address inside the command deck.
I like your gun. We played Tuvok on Star Trek Voyager. Voyager? Nope, nope, don't want to go down there.
Brothers and sisters, the road behind has been long and fraught with difficulty. Each and every one of you has surpassed my expectations by rapidly facilitating our arrival in the Commonwealth. You have accomplished this amazing feat without a hint of purpose or direction. And most impressively, without question. Now that the ship is in position, it is time to reveal our purpose and our beneath the Commonwealth. There is a cancer, known as the Institute. A malignant growth that needs to be cut before it infects the surface. They are experimenting with dangerous technologies that could prove to be the world's undoing for the second time in recent history. The Institute's
scientists
have created a weapon that transcends the destructive nature of the atom bomb. They call their creation the Synth. A robotic abomination of technology that is free-thinking and masquerades as a human being. This notion that a machine could be granted free will is not only offensive, but horribly dangerous. And like the atom, if it isn't harnessed properly, it has the potential of rendering us extinct as a species. I am not prepared to allow the Institute to continue this line of experimentation. Therefore, the Institute and their synths are considered enemies of the Brotherhood of Steel, and should be dealt with swiftly and mercilessly. This campaign will be costly, and many lives will be lost. But in the end, we will be saving humankind from its worst enemy.
Not as costly as that haircut.
Itself. Ad victoriam.
Ad victoriam.
Ad victoriam.
There's no time to waste when there's work to be done.
I care about them. The people of the Commonwealth.
Care about them? I thought we were preparing for war.
The Brotherhood is here to prevent a war by starting one of our own. The difference is Our war won't reduce civilization to ashes.
What do you want from me?
I want you to start taking responsibility for this planet. To start making a difference. And from what I've read in Paladin Dance's reports, you've already begun that journey. Seeing as he's one of my most respected field officers, you couldn't get a better recommendation. Therefore, from this moment forward,
hell yeah,
granting you the rank of knight. And, befitting your title, we're granting you a suit of power armor to protect you on the field of battle.
Yay.
Wear it with pride.
I'll do my best to live up to it.
I'm certain that you will.
Other Maxim is a legacy character? He actually was in Fallout 3? With the Pridwin and my cool. Staff.
Report to the flight deck for your new orders.
I'm gonna look that up real quick.
Welcome aboard the Pridwin, soldier. Make us proud.
Making his workshop. Okay, hold on. I want to double. Like, it's not that I don't believe you. I just want to see what he looked like in Fallout 3. I want to see the mention of him in Fallout 3. All right, let's see. Huh, Maxson is just used in, like, everything, because Roger Maxson was the founder, John Maxson was his grandson, High Elder of the Brotherhood of Steel in Fallout. Arthur Maxson was living in the Citadel in Last Descendant of John Maxson. Ah, there he is. So, Elder Maxson is Arthur Maxson. Cool.
Neat. I like it. Hey, Insane Ninja. Hi.
Yeah, no, he actually appears. His name is Arthur Maxson, and there's a screenshot on the wiki of him as a kid. Aw, you shouldn't smoke, dude. So yeah, this is Arthur Maxson. Calibration test successful. All bands and all. Trying to minimize weakness.
Status report.
Green across the board, sir. Nothing new.
Good. Carry on.
Cool, so these are the same guys as the ones from Fallout 3, which makes me think that they're not total scum-sucking dickheads.
So how did it look out there?
Paladin Dance.
A lot of work ahead of
there
us,
you
brother.
Are. How did it go with Elder Maxson?
Maxson seems so young compared to everyone else. You're okay with that?
Don't let his age fool you. Maxson's a brilliant tactician, a formidable warrior, and possesses an idealistic vision for the future of the Brotherhood. I'd follow him anywhere. Without question.
He's a very dedicated man. It sounds like he stands behind everything he's saying.
Of course he does. How could he afford not to? I just hope you appreciate how much of a chance I'm taking bringing you into the fold this quickly. Not to put too fine a point on it, but if you screw up, we go down together.
You're level 19 and have 7 power armors? Damn. That's a lot of power armors. I have 3 sets and I'm level 20-something.
So, what's all this about you being my sponsor?
Elder Maxson is understandably particular when it comes to new recruits. He believes in order to keep the Brotherhood strong, we have to bond as brothers. As your sponsor, it's my duty to travel with you throughout the Commonwealth to ensure that our ideals are being observed. That's why I'm so concerned about your performance in the field.
Don't worry. I'll be careful.
Good. Because we've got a lot of work ahead of us, and I don't want anything slowing us down. Now, I know you're eager to hop into a suit of power armor and take the fight to the Institute. But first things first. In order to be an effective part of the team, you need to learn your way around this ship and get to know its crew. Since I've been officially assigned to you as your sponsor, I'd recommend taking me along with you.
Do you need to come with me now?
It might help if I tagged along with you. On the other hand, you might want to make your first impression without a paladin standing over your shoulder. It's up to you.
You can come with me or wait until I'm done. It's up to you.
In that case, I prefer to tag along.
Aww.
If you change your mind, just let me know.
Alright, we'll send Kate back to the Red Rocket, I guess. Sorry, Kate. What level am I? I am level 24.
Hey.
Yes.
Your thoughts?
I'm pleased we were assigned to the same team. I think we can learn a lot from each other.
Your thoughts?
Give me a laser rifle and my power armor, and I'll take on the world.
Didn't have anything else.
Very well.
All right, let's go.
The food in the mess hall isn't bad. Well, as long as you don't smell it.
Ah, good. We're finally here. Just set the books down anywhere. I'll get to them as soon as I can.
So who are you?
What are you doing with all these books?
I suppose I could stop working for a moment to address your question.
Which books contain pertinent information?
Technical volumes, repair manuals, design philosophies, medical research. Anything that enhances the Brotherhood's knowledge. That's why I consider everything else a waste of paper.
Whatever suits you.
Expanding the technological knowledge of the Brotherhood is what suits me. Since it's obvious that you aren't who I was expecting, would you mind telling me why you're here?
Maxon wanted me to meet the crew. You were next on my list.
Ah, yes. You must be the new recruit described in Paladin Dance's report. Under normal circumstances, I'd provide you with a proper orientation of my department. However, I'm woefully behind setting up research patrols and getting bombarded with requests for technical documentation. Unfortunately, I'm lacking the personnel needed.
Aw, your little biscuit. That's adorable.
Maybe I could lend a hand.
That would be splendid. As you patrol the Commonwealth, keep your eyes open for blueprints, memos, manuals, books, charts. Anything containing...
Hi, Gamma. Welcome back.
Data. I'm authorized to pay you for each bundle of documents that you recover. And if you wish to be assigned to a research patrol, I have plenty of them waiting to be filled. In any event, it was a pleasure to meet you, Knight.
Cool. You know what? Since we're up here... Like, since we're up here... Yeah, my dog meat has on goggles and light dog armor and the bandana as well. But he's chilling out because Kate can't resist a redheaded Irish girl. You know? I heard a kitty. Kitty! They have a cat! That's awesome! Oh, look at him. Kitty. Look at the kitty. Guys, look at the kitty. Can I pet the cat? Press F to pet cat. Terrible. I'm sorry. I'll stop. I like cats. Leave me alone.
Glad you finally stopped by, soldier. Are you ready for your medical exam?
Oh, dear.
What kind of medical exam? I feel fine.
There's nothing to be alarmed about. I just have a few simple questions about your medical history. It's my responsibility to make sure that you don't bring anything up here that could pose a threat to the crew. I'm going to ask you a series of medical-related questions, and I'd like you to answer me to the best of your ability.
Romance cast.
First question. As a child, were you ever exposed to radiation for an extended period of time?
I could totally see Gamma romancing Dance. No, Silverlight. One cat is enough for me ever. Let's see.
There wasn't that much radiation around before the bombs fell.
Before the bombs? What? Let me check my notes. You were a vault dweller?
Yeah.
You're probably healthier than anyone else aboard. Anyway, sorry I missed that in your records. Just going down the list of questions. I'm sure you understand. Okay.
The ladies are jealous.
Have you ever had or come in contact with a person confirmed to be carrying a communicable disease?
Never been seriously sick in my life.
Good, good. Third question, and please answer honestly. Have you ever had sexual relations with any species considered non-human?
That happens often enough for you to have a question?
You'd be surprised how many wastelanders answer yes to that question. Fortunately, the Brotherhood finds that type of behavior absolutely distasteful.
Wow, I'm
Since
out.
You haven't spent too much time in the wasteland. I'll assume your answer
I'm out.
Is... Last question. Would you have any problems pulling the trigger on an enemy of the Brotherhood, whether they're human, formerly human, or machine?
That's more of a morals question, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. I feel that the mental state of the crew is just as important as the physical. Anyone that hesitates firing in combat due to misguided moral standards certainly isn't Brotherhood material. So what about you? Would you have a problem with it?
If my life's in danger, I'll do whatever it takes to defend myself.
That's an acceptable answer. And the most common. Hmm. Excellent. I think I've got all the information I need.
He just magicked away that clipboard.
I see no reason to prevent you from beginning your duties immediately. If you ever need medical assistance, you let me know.
Okay. No, yeah. There goes your hope to live with the Brotherhood of Gorus is introduced in a future expansion. Gamma, would you actually do such a thing? Because, oh my god, the claws, though. Getting into the moment and then just... No, that's probably a bad idea. Yeah, but he just poofed that thing away.
Looking for medical assistance, soldier?
No, I'm just stealing all your shit, but thanks. Because no one seems to care if I take all this, so I'm taking it. Like, if I was getting in trouble, I would be taking it, but you're letting me, so... Guess what I'm taking? All
Good
of it.
Good to see you again, Knight. Anything I can do to help?
No, I'm okay, thanks. But yeah, you'd think that the doctor would catch something like you being 210 years old. You'd just make clipboard mittens for Gorus if that was the case.
There, try it now.
Nothing.
No matter how many
Dr. Ingram, there's always another fight ahead of us.
Recruit I heard about.
You're the one who
not what I was expecting.
Got it.
Says the one who's wearing the shell of her power armor.
Thanks, brother.
What were you expecting? The last batch of recruits we took on were wastelanders. Dirty, beaten up, looking for a handout. They were desperate and looking for an easy out. You look like you're here for us. Anyway, since you came down here to meet me, we made
I like it, Gala. Or Silver.
My name's Ingram, and this lovely little grease pit is where you'll usually find
like the semi-automatic weapons. Or
heard one's about to crash into the ground, or a robot's gone haywire.
Wow, fully automatic. Ingram. Hi, Insane Ninja. And yeah, I mean, honestly, why do you guys have so much of my stuff?
Is this where I get my power armor?
Ha! That's always the first question from the new guys. Let's see. I just fixed up a pretty decent T-60 suit. The left leg actuator's a bit sticky, but it'll keep the creeps off of you. It's sitting in Bay 3.
T-60?
There isn't a day that goes by on this tub without five or six things breaking down. And since I'm stuck in this rig, I'm not quite as spry as I used to be. The work tends to pile up.
Actually, you seem to be getting around really well.
I suppose it's better than the alternative. Anyway, if you need any work done on your power armor, feel free to use the workshops around here. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to get back to work.
Is that it? Huh.
Building something?
What does the Brotherhood of Night steal? Increases strength. Cool. You're looking forward to getting an XO1? Hmm. Alright, let's see. It's Bay 4, Bay 3. She uses the suits as a way to get around. Who, Proctor Ingram? Why?
Unless you'd like getting shot, never turn your back on a gunner.
Treat your power armor well, and it can get you through anything.
Oh. Neat. I hadn't noticed that. Wonder what happened to her.
list of maintenance fixes keeps getting longer and longer.
Yeah, I see that now. I didn't see it before because I was looking at our head. That's interesting. That's cool. She honestly probably has them. They're probably just skinned to be invisible. Yes. Barrels like paper. Yes, it does.
Step forward, Knight. Even though they've locked me in this blasted cage, I promise that I won't bite.
Why are you in there?
I'm glad you asked. Now, this is the stowage depot, and I, as you probably already guessed, am the ship's quartermaster, Proctor Teagan. The powers that be
are
locked in here, so I can keep an eye on the Brotherhood's valuables. If you need to stock up on supplies before you head out on a mission, this is the place to buy them.
Buy them? Since when does the military sell equipment to its own soldiers?
Since someone dropped a whole bunch of bombs and blew up every single factory that manufactured weapons and ammunition. Keeping the Brotherhood supplied takes caps, and everyone contributes to the cause.
And that makes sense.
By having a constant flow of caps, I'm able to buy whatever you bring me. Yeah, I'm mostly interested in weapons, but I'll take anything useful. Of course, if you're just looking to make a few caps on the side, I might have some extra work for you to do.
What sort of extra work are we talking
about?
Don't
eyeball me.
No. It's nothing like you're thinking. It just involves a little bit of heavy lifting and interacting with the local farms. And since I'm stuck up here manning this one-man zoo, I need someone to do the legwork for me.
Natch.
After you're done with the meet and greet, we can discuss the details.
Hey, you're last on my tour.
In the meantime, if you ever need anything else, gun, mod, even ammo, you just let me know.
When it comes to keeping the grid
running... Unstoppable Wanderer, what? Oh, hey. The best. I just got an achievement for hitting level 25. Nice! Fuck you looking at me, maybe. Blew up all the factories, with the exception of the pit, which is run by our Brotherhood Paladin from the Capital Wasteland, who could easily survive the discontinued with plenty of ammo and steel. Wait. Good point. Good point, Gamma. Alright. So let's see. Should get this damn last Black Widow one. Yeah, screw it. Let's get the last Black Widow one. $600. That's crazy.
Hey.
Go ahead.
Paladin.
What do you want?
Your thoughts?
I really should have my armor adjusted while I'm here.
Your thoughts?
With the Brotherhood behind us, we'll never fall.
Your thoughts?
Remember. We're out here representing the Brotherhood. Let's make them proud.
Is it just me, or does Dance feel like an actor doing his George Clooney impression?
Your thoughts?
I think you should stay on point. Your instincts seem to be right on target.
Nothing else I needed.
Affirmative.
But yeah, most likely Ingram's, her model is, it's the same wireframe as everyone else. They just use, Basically, they just chroma keyed her legs out.
The damn ship steady?
That is pretty cool, though. Like, that's legitimately pretty awesome. Am I wrong, though? He's not done by George Clooney himself, obviously. I looked it up. It's a guy that's done a bunch of voice acting with, like, Superman-type characters. But he does. It feels like the guy who does Superman's voice doing a George Clooney impression.
They creep me the heck out.
I mean, it's not a bad thing. Dance is a pretty cool dude, but that's what it sounds like to me. That's definitely what it sounds like to me. Bonk. 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 What's my carry weight up to now?
Tighten up the meter.
What's that?
Split the difference.
Okay. You like Deacon, but he's not a romance. I haven't met Deacon yet, so.
Elder.
Now that you've familiarized yourself with the Prigman's crew, are you ready for your next assignment, sister?
What sort of assignment are we talking about?
The kind of assignment where all of the training you've done finally begins to pay off. Let's get right to it, then. Shall we? Take a look over there. That's Fort Strong. And it's infested with super mutants. Having those aberrations of nature close enough to smell is making me sick to my stomach. To make matters worse, they're sitting on top of a massive stockpile of Fat Man shells we could use in our campaign. I want you to head over there, wipe out everything that moves, and secure that stockpile.
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Consider it done.
Look, I realize you're eager to take the fight to the Institute.
Dance loved
but
that.
To wait. The Brotherhood cannot allow those abominations to have a nuclear arsenal at their fingertips.
It'll be a pleasure to exterminate that mutant filth.
Damn right.
We have a vertibird on standby, fully armed, and ready to depart. Use it to carry our message to Fort Strong, and wipe those dirty mutants from the face of the earth. Dismissed.
All right, let's do it. Let's go cause some hell. Shall rain fire down upon our enemies until they are naught but ash. Huh. That was a very specific thing to say, and it sounded really cool. So what do we need to do here? I did board the vertibird gunship. Come on. Don't do this to me, game. Game. What is this? The wrong one? No, that's obviously the right one. I'm a bit confused. The other one is at the airport. Oh my god, I have to get into a vertibird to get to a vertibird? Because that seems dumb. This isn't the vertibird you're looking for.
The two in the head, no stay dead. Advice to live.
I'm confused! I'm so confused. I can't take it. Fuck all the things. I am using my HUD. It doesn't make any sense. So look. Okay, so there's the door, right? So I gotta go in this thing, right? Okay, so I go in this thing. That takes me down. I love being able to do that, to just jump wherever you want. Yeah. Now see, it just tells me to do the thing again!
What other vertebrate? I only see one down here.
Feels like you can take on the world.
Remember your three C's.
On the beach? What on the... Nice to watch me squeeze into that armor? Yeah, apparently. I'm sure Gamma's okay with that.
Can you believe synths are replacing humans with exact duplicates?
No.
This is our supply depot. Unless you're here, I'll take care of you.
So my dear Gamma, is he your type? Is that a personification of your type for future reference? Okay, I'm gonna just... Alright. Board the vertebrate gunship. Okay, yeah, I'm trying, but it's not letting me. Doesn't he, though? It's like, alright, you know what, hold on, I'm gonna look this up. So Show No Mercy is the name of the quest. I wanna see if there's an issue with it. See if the wiki's updated yet. No, nothing. I broke the game. Actually, under the vertebrate, you can't tell that on the map. The correct vertebrate is on the ground, different from the one which takes the vertebrate. Okay, so that's what other people are saying. They're saying the exact same thing you are, Gamma. I just don't know what the issue is. So let's go down. And see what that happens. See, because that one doesn't have a minigun. It seems like this whole quest thing is shoot stuff in the minigun. Rush reveals giant nuclear torpedo on state TV by accident. Russia. You never cease to amaze me. I feel like I might have broken some things, yeah. You've got a minigun. I want a minigun.
It's only a matter of time before I find you.
Well, this is frustrating.
Anything useful?
Yeah, not that I want to steal from him because I feel bad about it later. I'm still very confused. And now there's not even a map mark. Hold on. Oh, because there's no active quest. Just use the stupid VATS thing. Are you going to sleep, Insane Ninja? If so, sleep well. There, we're using Vans. I'm so confused. Hang around as long as you can, Jeff. That's okay. Well, if you fall asleep, sleep well. See, now it's telling me to do this one.
I think you should stay on point. Your instincts seem to be right on target.
Okay. All right, hold on. Thing again. This is very awkward. Okay, so I gotta get on this one. Wait, hold on. So yeah, there's one already down there. And it's getting picked up right now. Fuck. That might be what the problem is. Great. Okay, let me see if there's a load from earlier. Oops. Alright, we'll go back here. We'll load that one. Which gives me T60 series ball. Oh, see, it's already coming up. Shit. I might be stuck because of this. Jump onto the railing into it. I can't really because it's, you gotta be down here because of this one.
I'd gladly lay down my life if it keeps humanity from the apocalypse.
Remember your three C's. Cranium, crotch, center mass.
Cranium, crotch, center mass. Good to know. So basically it's that one right there. It's that one. Maybe if I fuck with the console commands. Like, can't disable and enable it or something like that. Give me a minute, I gotta turn the sound off. Alright, I'm gonna try a couple of ways to possibly fix this. So, one of the ways that might fix it is if we fast travel away. So we'll fast travel away and then fast travel right back to the airport and see if that fixes it. If not, we'll just leave the game and start over, maybe? And close the game and start it, restart it, that might fix it. This is a bit frustrating. Said I fast travel back to the Pridwin and see if this fixes it. Excuse me. Interesting. Hey, there we go. That fixed.
It's the only way to fly.
Welcome aboard, Knight.
All right.
And we're cleared for release.
So I get to gun down some super mutants. Looks like someone tore chunks out of this thing's wing. This would be the perfect time for a Long Tall Sally by Little Richard. Which is way more 80s than 50s, but still. If anybody gets the reference, you get 5 points. The points are meaningless, but you get them. But they are yours.
Guard acquired. I'll try and keep them in your sights.
Oh god, a super mutant behemoth? Oh shit! Kitten. Kitten. Okay, kitten. My headphone cord, please.
Primary target down. Look at that thing bleed. I'm gonna find a place to set her down and then hightail it back to the Pridwin for repairs.
You've recently been the go-to guy. Oh, I'm sorry. Well, I don't know if I should say I'm sorry. You know. You know what I should be using? Righteous Thorn. Oh shit! There's a legendary up here. It's kind of scary. I'm gonna let Dance weaken him for me. Dance is a tough guy. He can handle himself. And I'm gonna flank. There's the mutate. Alright, acrobat's metal left leg. Well, that is a left leg armor, alright. Good job, Dance. Do Glass Dance the rocket at Archimedes? No. What happens if you do? I didn't know that was even a thing. What happens if you do that? Well, hey, look, they use the same pipes.
There must be something significant in this area to merit these words.
But yeah, I didn't know that was an option. Nothing happens, he's in power armor, so the synths worked. Yeah, but he's not in full power armor, he's not wearing a helmet. Should have liquefied him inside. He was in your thing? Gamma, that's lewd.
So, this area seems to be in disarray. I wonder if this is recent.
Wish a buckethead would show up. I'd rip his legs clean off.
Hey.
Go ahead.
Paladin Dance.
What do you want?
How do you feel about our relationship?
I think we have the potential to be quite an effective team, if you learn to cooperate.
That was all.
Affirmative.
He's not wearing his helmet now. We're on a mission. I know, Gamma. I was teasing you. He does put the helmet on sometimes, but not always. He does his little twirl when he puts it on, and it's kind of adorable.
I am tired of this. What's that? This commonwealth. End of your blood!
Threat neutralized.
Gamma, contain your erections. Come on.
Batch of the M42s this morning. I've only seen the specs for these little beauties on paper, so Private Bertram and I snuck down to take an early look. When I heard that the eggheads were designing a manned portable nuke launcher, I thought they were nuts. But they actually got the damn thing to work. And after seeing the real thing sitting right in front of me, I think they could be just enough to tip the balance of this war in our favor. Imagine the look on the enemy's face when we get dropped into Anchorage carrying these babies. They won't know what hit them.
The problem with nukes is that they tend to fuck everything up for everybody.
What is it?
Trash to pick through here. Searching through it could prove beneficial.
I am Super Mutant. I am Death.
Hates half the tapes, half the actors sound like they were bored out of their mind. Yeah.
Yes, you are Super Mutant. I'm annoyed. Torch to go.
Tape is off. Target eliminated. Last Victoria.
See, that's the thing is, like, whenever there's tapes, I usually want to read them because I can, like, I know how to act, and I can put some emotion into it. Whereas, half the time, like, these guys is just, and then the thing happened, and then there were more things that happened, and then some things happened. And you can tell that half the time they just don't give a shit. They're just reading their scripts. Where if you're doing it right, you know, you make it sound emotional. You pause, you put inflection, you emphasize certain things. It does make a difference.
Sweet.
Remain vigilant. This place may appear abandoned, but that doesn't mean we should drop our guard.
Hello, what have we here? U.S. Covert Operation Manuals. More difficult to detect when sneaking. Nice. That scientist obviously didn't think the war could be won with Fat Man monsters, so that voice held no confidence or optimism. As of today, command at Fort Strong has passed to me. I'm looking forward to helping the U.S. Army test some of its experimental weapon systems at our facility. I've already had the men preparing the island for testing operations by tearing down the old barracks and constructing a simulated town. Since we'll be fighting the enemy on an urban front, I think the best way to test these weapons is by seeing how well they punch through civilian structures. We've been testing the new batch of T-51B power armor suits that the Army Corps of Engineers just rolled off the assembly line. I'm impressed with the amount of protection they afford our soldiers, yet allow them a great deal of mobility. I've noticed that the soldiers are still having trouble jumping in these things. Because of the suit's weight, they often tip over on hard landings. I've had the maintenance boys look at it, and they're suggesting adding a gyroscope and shock absorbers to the lower torso. I'll pass it up the chain and see if we can get Washington to spend the extra money it'll cost for the modifications. Things are starting to heat up overseas, so Washington is pushing to cut our project turnaround times in half. I told them that would be dangerous, but it seems like we don't have much of a choice. I've decided to split my staff into Alpha Team and Bravo Team so we can work on two projects at the same time. The manpower will be reduced, but I'm convinced that we'll still be able to maintain our new schedule. I'm going to put Alpha Team on the power armor and Bravo Team and Bravo on the new M42 Fat Man launchers. Alpha Team just shipped out the first batch of T-51B suits to the front in China. Reports are already coming in that the suits are performing better than expected, chewing through the enemy tanks and armor like they were paper. Word has it that some kind of enemy troops are even surrendering when they catch sight of the power armor troops hauling around their 5mm miniguns. Looks like Alpha Team has earned them a weekend pass in Boston. Bravo Team is having a heck of a time getting the M42's not to shoot far enough away from its firing position. The problem is that the warhead is still too heavy to fire the distance required. Our simulated soldiers are soaking far too many rads and suffering blast burns. One of the technicians has suggested a radical idea of using a conventional depleting subcharge to catapult the round rapidly out of the launcher. His calculations look sound, so I'm going to let him give it a try. Oh, there's one of them. After a few design setbacks and the loss of one of our testing squads, we finally perfected the M42's launcher's firing mechanism. Washington has been riding me to wrap this project up, but with a weapon this potent, I was inclined to take my time. We've sent the launchers ahead to the supply yard in Mississippi, and we're just waiting for the go-ahead to ship the warheads wherever they need to go. Hopefully, we can get those nukes out there before the month is out. I don't feel comfortable sleeping 20 feet above enough nukes to reduce this island to ash. Oh dear.
Judging from the amount of dust present, it's safe to assume we're the first.
Yeah, shut up, Dance. God damn it. Gamma, just remember, Bethesda doesn't give a shit about canon. God damn it. There we go.
Yes.
Stayed at this location in quite a while.
Yeah, that's the thing you gotta remember, is Bethesda's never given a shit about consistency. Even in their own writing.
Much left to properly identify these remains.
The worst part is that Operation Anchorage was part of Bethesda's, not... I'm sorry, Gamma. I know. I know.
Watch your step. There's quite a bit of debris here.
Dance, I'm okay. I got it. Look, I survived the fucking war. I can survive this. Can't do that while in power armor? Oh, fuck you then. Damn it, it's okay to cry on the outside here. This is a safe space for crying on the outside. Purified water. Thanks. You must get drink, shower, turn shortly. Okay.
What? Who's there?
Oh god, a legendary mutant. I thought that was a legendary mutant hound. I was gonna be scared. Nah! Dance, we have a problem. Oh god, my health is low. Nice. What the hell? It's a weird looking missile launcher. Lucky metal right leg. Okay.
We need to get out of this radiation now.
We'll be okay. Don't be a pussy, Dance. Last thing we need is a pussy-ass fucking Brotherhood of Steel and Paladin. One floor at a time. Holy shit. Holy shit. Forklift only. Never thought I'd say this, but you miss Moira as a shopkeeper. I miss Moira too. You, like, lover or hater, Moira did her job well, and she was always there to be a good shopkeeper when you needed. It was your home like, your house was in Megaton, and so was Moira, and you always knew where she was, like, right away, because she was so early, you know, introduced so early. So you knew that it was very easy to just be like, hey, I have somewhere to go as my home base and a place to sell stuff all in one. I feel like merchants are super rare in this game. Like, comparatively. And I get that their whole thing is, you need to build a settlement, and then blah 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 blah, but what if I just don't want to? I don't give a shit about the settlement building. I could not physically care less about the settlement building.
Look at this place. You must hate these mutants as much as I do.
Eh, well.
Why do you hate super mutants so much?
Hate's too gentle a word. These monstrosities are just another example of man blindly taking a step forward, only to wind up stumbling two steps back. I've been fighting for years, trying to put a stop to this madness. And just when I thought we were getting the upper hand, along come the synths. I've seen what these super mutants do to people. Can you imagine what the synths would do to us if they ever got the upper hand? It would be Armageddon repeated, and maybe the end of everything that we hold dear. Look, I don't mean to bore you with my rhetoric. I just want you to understand how important these missions are.
How could synths bring about our destruction?
If the synths reached the point where they outnumbered mankind, how long would it take for them to decide we were no longer necessary? They certainly possess the capability to make more of their own kind, so we'd become expendable.
Damn.
With Institute technology on their side, nothing could stop them, not even the Brotherhood. It's a nightmare scenario almost too terrible to contemplate. Anyway, that's enough of that. What's important here is that you got the job done and secured these warheads. You should head back up to the Pridwin and talk to Maxon. I'm sure he'll want to debrief you as soon as possible. Dismissed.
Okay. Yeah, 6 merchants that make you 15 caps every 3 days, that's nothing. Just feel like currency is not necessarily an important part of this game anymore. You craft your own stuff, which means that, you know, weapons aren't super rare. They're not. Like, everybody drops weapons all the time. And you just break them down and use them to make your current weapon better. You know? So currency doesn't seem to be a thing anymore. Oh, cool, it tells you when your spotlight's on.
Take care of the shells.
See? It's got a little spotlight function thing. That's pretty cool. Considering you need ammo and 1/3 of your iron costs 10 caps, you kind of need money because you can't make ammo for some reason.
Yeah.
I feel like, you know, they took out so much good stuff out of the game. It really is a step back from Fallout 3, or from Fallout New Vegas in a lot of ways. Like, the hyper-simplification of it, I get that they were trying to do, but it just doesn't feel the same. I mean, I'm having more fun with it today than I was yesterday because I'm not as depressed, but just took over 250 cells to kill 10 super mutants who in turn gave you 60 caps worth of gear. There isn't a profit in there at all. That's really not. No.
Sir.
Outstanding work at Fort Strong, soldier.
Damn right.
So, what happens at Fort Strong now?
Paladin Dance is supervising the transfer of the Fat Man warheads to the Prudwood. They'll provide quite an edge to our arsenal. I've also ordered a detachment to occupy the location and use it as a staging area to protect the eastern side of the airport. All in all, you handed us quite a valuable location.
Too bad it wasn't the Institute.
Not to worry, Knight. You'll be dealing with them sooner than you think. In order to bring the Institute to its knees, we need to use every weapon at our disposal. I try to supply my soldiers with the best. That's why I'm giving you these. Signal grenades can call a vertibird to your location when you need aerial transport. Simply throw one to the ground, and the vertibird will hone in on the unique electromagnetic smoke it emits. Once you're aboard, use the map on your pitboy to interface with the pilot's navigation system, so he'll be able to take you wherever you need.
The best weapon for survival out here is a pocket full of caps.
Signal grenades are usually reserved for our paladins. In your case, you should be grateful that I'm making an exception. Now, I'm sure you're aware that Fort Strong was simply the first step towards the liberation of the Commonwealth. An even greater task lies ahead. By now, I'm sure you've deduced that our arrival in the Commonwealth wasn't coincidental. We're here because of a unique energy reading recorded by Paladin Dance's recon team. According to our scribes, the reading indicated a level of technology that only the Institute could achieve. The moment this information came to light, our mission became clear. The Institute and everyone responsible for the creation of the synths must be eliminated at all costs. To accomplish this goal, we need to locate the Institute's headquarters. I've had our scribes meticulously searching the Commonwealth, but they've come up empty-handed.
Where do I start?
I want you to get out there and become our eyes and ears on the ground. You seem to have a vested interest in locating the Institute before we met, so I'm confident you'll travel in the right circles. If you discover a way in, I need you to report it to me immediately. Any questions, Knight?
Aren't there any pre-war records about the Institute that might help us?
Our records indicate that the Institute was born from the remnants of a pre-war educational facility, the Commonwealth Institute of Technology. The ruins of the facility are at the center of the city, but we've already searched them thoroughly. The location appears to have been abandoned long ago, so it appears that the trail ends there. Anything else, Knight?
What about those energy readings Paladin Dance's recon team detected?
Our scribes are confident that the energy readings are from Institute technology, due to the unusually high frequency. But the source is unknown. We're still detecting them on occasion. But by the time we send a team to investigate, they disappear. Just watch your step. I wouldn't be surprised if the energy reading were caused by some type of Institute weapon. Is there anything else?
Any suggestions on where I should look next?
I'd pursue your lead regarding Dr. Amari. I'm not certain if she's a crackpot, or if she can genuinely assist your search. But our sources say she has some interesting technology at her disposal. Anything else, Knight?
Not right now, Elder.
Very well, then. Dismissed.
So, stupid console port of a game. Seriously, the whole dialogue wheel is such bullshit. Like, up for questions, down for affirmative, right for no, left for witty commentary. Oh my god, I'm so done with that. But yeah, you can mod all the guns you want, but if you don't have ammo and can't afford ammo, who the hell cares? I kind of have just been, like, cycling between the four different guns that I have. So, like, I've got... So, you know, I've got my machine gun. I've got my shotgun. I've got my sniper rifle somewhere. And I've got my energy weapon. And I just cycle between the four of them whenever I need it. Alright, let's go up to drop the suit of armor off. I'm surprised I haven't found many more bobbleheads, considering how much exploring I've been doing. Shale, what are you doing back there? Weird-ass cat. You know what I am gonna do? I'm gonna go get some more crackers, because those things are fucking delicious, and I can't put them down. I'll be right back. I found like five.
So much walking. What
to do more fighting.
Yeah, I found 5.
So many humans, not many super mutants.
Gotcha. This launcher looks so weird now.
Someday, super mutants kill everything. Strong want to smash something.
Jeez, he never shuts up. He never shuts up. I feel like I'm never gonna not have a bunch of shit in my bags that I don't need. I never seem to be below 250 weight. It's ridiculous. Frame rate graininess. I'm sorry.
Fist was weak leader. Strong glad to be rid of him. Strong want to smash something.
Yeah, I don't know why I can't seem to get under any weight. I only carry around, like, I'm carrying around a 1-pound vault suit. Oh no. And then the rest is stuff that I have equipped, right? I have a couple of... I could probably drop the mines off and the grenades off, because I don't use much of them. But I only have the weapons that I actually use. And that. The rest is just like, I don't know where the extra weight's coming from. You know what? Hold on. I don't have any junk on me, that's the thing. I don't keep junk on me. I don't carry weapon mods around with me. I just dog me. I swear to God, get out of my fucking way. Dog me. You piece of shit.
All my weapon mods I keep in here, okay? See? It goes straight from ammo to misc. There's no weapon mods there. All in here. They only weigh a half a pound anyway.
So many humans. Not many super mutants. Human carry so much. Strong only need hammer.
No, I don't want those crispy squirrel. That's gonna be so. Okay, hold on. Let's... Alright, so ammo, as per usual, has no weight. So ammo has no weight. Don't have to worry about that. Let's drop off some of these grenades and mines and shit. I don't even plan on ever using these, so. I do have a problem with pets, they're annoying. I hate dogs. Alright, so let's see. Okay, so that puts me down to 4 pounds. 4 pounds right there, okay? Which means that all of the junk, all the miscellaneous stuff that's effectively weightless, I have 4 pounds worth, right? So let's get our armor back, right? Okay, so let's get our armor back. So 39 pounds worth of armor. We'll put it on the wedding ring again. Wear our sunglasses because of the way they give us one perception. Put on the road leathers because that's so that we're not naked. Which honestly looks pretty badass.
Humans all look.
I can put the other road leathers in here. And see, I do have Agatha's dress. Yeah. Okay, so that's 38 pounds worth of stuff that I've got. What did I just pick up? Okay, sword. So if we take back our guns, or 107, probably wouldn't hurt to cut back on the amounts of some of those cans. I doubt you need to have 60 buff out on hand. So weapons puts me up to 119. Yeah, let's leave all the drugs. Just take some food. Cat, could you lay down? I'm gonna leave all the Nuka-Cola in the cooler. All the drugs. Out, cat. There. It's because they added weight to chems, that's why. I mean, that shit adds up. Oh, I got 60 of them, yeah. I mean, look at this, watch. So we're at 167, now we're at 173. I mean, 6 pounds there. Okay. Can I take off the road leathers and see, like, just what I look like without it underneath? That's the silliest thing there is, to run around in the wasteland like that. That's ridiculous.
Someday, super mutants kill everything.
That's good shit. Okay. Alright, so let's go check out our quests. I have a personal storage container. I swear, if I ever play one of these Fallout games, I'll fucking mod in infinite wait. Just find the game too frustrating otherwise. Yeah, but I mean, you can do that. It's easy. It's easy. You can just adjust your carry. You can go into the console commands and add your carry weight up to like 10,000, or just set it to 9999999999, and then you got a bazillion carry weight forever and ever 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 and ever.
Our vertebrae should give us the air.
Shale's such a good kitten, aren't you? Yes, you are. You little shit.
Attention, this is a reminder. All recovered technology must be presented immediately to Proctor Quinlan for evaluation.
You think the Commonwealth looks bad?
Anyone found in possession of undocumented technologies will be subject to inquiry and punishment.
Why are you in my bed?
Okay, sure. Firing. Everything holding together?
Trust me. You know.
Good. Firing.
Damn it! Then there's everything else. Alright, alright. Everything looks nominal. Scuttle the ship. Thanks, Initiate.
Sure. Anytime.
God, these guys have all this stuff of mine. It's ridiculous.
That's it. Got it.
Okay, not bad.
Do you know what a 10-pound cockroach can do to a buoyancy regulator? I can guess. Don't get smart. You want to see the Brotherhood's greatest warship brought down by bugs? Alright, alright. Just don't tell Ingram, okay?
Fine. But there's a reason. Food's not allowed near the instrumentation.
I mean, these guys don't care if I take all my stuff back, so... You know, I'm gonna. You can't stop me.
Felder Maxon ordered me to follow him to the gates of hell, I'd be the first one to kick them over.
Ad victorium, sister.
Mm-hmm. Something like that. What? Huh? Yeah. Power armor batteries is just a strange thing. Alright, let's see. Questy quests. Let's go do this stuff with the Minutemen. We haven't messed with Preston in a while. Let's do that.
What? What's wrong, kitten? What's wrong, kitten? Are you an adorable kitten? Are you an adorable kitten? Yes, you are. You're an adorable kitten.
And I love you, you little shit.
It's okay.
Ooh, you okay? Silly cat. Huh? Oh, kitten.
So dead.
Huh? I can't even see up here, I'm sorry. Anybody else? Didn't think so. Okay, good. Glad you see things my way. Now, excuse me, I have places to go. I think it's funny that there's not actually a running animation, so when you fast travel somewhere and switch to third person, it has to
start it.
Otherwise, you just kind of float forward and it adjusts your, there's some head bob. But there's not an actual running animation when you're in there. It's kind of like how the, oh god, what was it? I don't remember the game. I think it was Crysis or something, where, since it doesn't play in first person, it doesn't have animations for a lot of the stuff, so you just, when you crouch and you peek over stuff, it's like looking at one of those little statue busts of, that they made of paper that accordion out. It's like looking at one of those. It's silly. Nope. Nobody here but us assassins.
What? I hear something. It was nothing. I hear something. Nice try.
Fuck. Oh, man. That's so cool.
What's that?
Here,
I just think that's really that's really cool that you can shoot the nuke and it blows them up. Wrecked. Wrecked is exactly right. It is an accurate description. I hate that there's not an auto-run key anymore. Fucking console port. Oh, damn it, this might have been a bad idea. Shit. Might have been, nope, not a bad idea. It's a good idea. It's X by default. Oh, hey. What's Q then? Screw that, I'm rebinding that shit. I hate that they rebound all the keys, though. It's stupid. Q is VAT. No, Q is not VATS. V is VATS. V for VATS. V for Vault Tech Assistant. Same as it's always been. Excuse me? Confused by what just happened. Yeah, I know by default, but I remapped that shit. Because it's supposed to be on the right keys. I put as many of the controls back to Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas style controls as I could. Hey, Preston. Thanks for leaving all my stuff out.
Excuse me.
Everyone's here, General. There it is. Pretty impressive, huh? Its real name is Fort Independence, but the Minutemen always just called it Castle. Now you can see why I wanted to take it back.
Because you have a stick up your ass about it?
Why do we need this place again?
The radio tower is the most important part, but with a bit of work, this place could be a really strong outpost. You know what I mean?
Hmm.
Definitely. For 600 years old, it's in pretty good shape.
That's right. They don't make them like they used to. We take this place back, people will know we mean business. Our primary objective is to clear the courtyard. That's where we should see the most opposition. The wall on this side is the most exposed. But if we circle around south, we could also reach the main gate.
What are we waiting for? Let's just get in there and shoot those lobsters.
No. If we split up, we can flank them from both sides. It'll be like shooting fish in a barrel.
Why not let them come to us? We set up a firing line on this side and you can draw them out.
Well, General, what do you think?
Pincer attack.
Let's hit him from both sides.
We'll split up and you can join whichever side you think needs the extra support. All right, people. You heard the General. Let's move out. Try not to draw their attention until we're in position.
Good kitten. Good kitten. You dumbass, still using laser muskets and shit. Aw, you started attention, you silly kitten. Sorry, when she grabs at my hand and pulls it up for more petting, it's kind of hard to say no. Alright, I don't know who the hell you people are, but let's go.
Don't worry, General. We're not afraid of those Mire Lurks.
Mire Lurks? Is that really what this is all about? Mire Lurks? Oh my god, you guys are pussies. Alright, let's go. That's pretty cool looking. Oh, I should probably switch to. Hey! Really like them. I think they're cool. It's a cool design, but you know. Whoa, hey. Sorry, dude. You should have used a stim pack. I can just take the eggs instead of destroying them? That's useful.
Bingo.
Ballistic weapons primarily do. Ooh, plasma, the weapon of tomorrow. That's badass power armor.
That way. Here's how we're gonna play this. You hold here in the courtyard and take care of any eggs you find. The General and I will clear the walls.
Yes, sir.
Let's do this, General.
Okay.
Opening fire. Wait. Found you.
Come on, Preston. What kind of a bastard are you? A flamer, finally. Okay. Well, easy enough. Queen. mean? Oh God! Oh God! So... Maybe the Myrler Queen will forgive us.
What?
Everyone's here, General.
Oh, come on.
Pretty impressive, huh?
Wait, can I, like, load up another save? No. Oh, okay.
In this Fort Independence, but the Minutemen always just called it the castle. Now you can see why I wanted to take it back.
Why do we?
The radio tower is the most important.
Uh-huh. Definitely.
That's right. What are we waiting for?
No.
Why not?
Hmm. Yeah. Okay.
Well, General, what do you think?
Yep. Let's go ahead and guns blazing.
Just get in there and hit him with everything we've got.
If you say so. All right, people. You heard the General. Let's move out. Try not to draw their attention until we're in position.
Okay. Try to get better weapons, you losers. Good God. Laser musket is just the silliest of ideas.
Hey, pal.
What's up? Change of plans?
Nah, let's go. Actually, you know what? Laser weapons are probably the worst idea here.
Like they've been nesting. We're gonna have to take out the day. They'll be back before we know it.
Lurks like to hold up inside old buildings, so the walls are probably full of them.
Sure looks that way. Here's how we're gonna play this. You hold here in the courtyard and take care of any eggs you find. The General and I will clear the walls.
Yes, sir.
Let's do this, General.
I don't want to waste the ammo. I lied. This is faster. Good. That's one down. Oh god.
What the hell was that?
I can tell you what it wasn't. It wasn't anything I want to mess with. Gonna shoot it from right back here where it's nice and safe. Oh hell. Come on, come on, come on. Oh shit. I should have brought a fat man, you're absolutely right. Kitten! Being so kitten! Shit! Shit! Jesus fuck! This bitch right here. Wow, what bullshit. definitely not the best way to do a boss fight. Smart way to do a boss fight, but... Could you... The acid attack is, yeah, it's a little bullshit. That's the reason I'm doing it this way. Oh god. That's the reason I'm doing it this way, where I'm fighting from inside a fucking building, which I think is really cheap. It's a cheesy way to do this fight, but it's the way to survive this fight, so. Because, like, you kind of need to. Queen Mirelark meat. Mm. Heavy metal left arm. Hell yeah.
All right. Good work, people.
Hi.
We need to focus on taking the castle back.
All right.
Yes.
Anything left of the old transmitter.
If that radio transmitter over there had power, well, we could broadcast to the whole Commonwealth.
See what you can do with it. I'm gonna go see what else is left around this old place.
Once I power this up, we'll be ready to broadcast.
Oh, I see. It's more bullshit power forced... Which one is it? Oh, I don't have enough aluminumers. Alright, I'll just make a large generator. I don't have any aluminum. For fuck's sake, really?
A good reminder of what we're fighting for.
In a raid boss, it shouldn't be hard, but I shouldn't require healing every goddamn 10 seconds to live through it. Yeah. Gives you 60 caps worth of loot. I know, right? It's not even a table, it's a rug on the table. That's so dumb. Just gonna scrap everything in here because I don't give a shit. I mean, like, all of your beds and stuff, but... I should need to rebuild this place. I guess if I'd found the missile launcher, it would have been a lot easier, but... How was I supposed to know that was even there? You know?
I saw that thing coming out of the water, I was sure we were all
dead. Wow, we really did it. I've been watching the Minutemen fall to pieces for so long, I just... This is really something. Now we've got to pay off on what we've started. Bring the whole Commonwealth together and make it last this time. So, you know, back to business. But with Radio Freedom up and running, we can broadcast alerts to you anywhere, anytime. Mm-hmm. Which reminds me. I've got another trouble spot for you to check
out.
I've got something a bit different for you. Our scouts have found a promising spot for a new settlement. Once you clear it out, set up a radio beacon to let settlers know about it. Before you know it, we'll have a thriving new farm instead of wasteland. We'll take back the Commonwealth, one piece at a time.
Okay.
I wish more people could see this. Remind them what it's all about.
That's my bit. Okay. Okay.
The smooth sounds of Diamond City Radio are brought to you by the following. The Commonwealth Weaponry. It's a dangerous world.
Uh-huh. All right, you know what, let's let that be our capstone for now. We'll take another break. We'll cut the episode here so that we're keeping them in kind of 2 to 2.5 hour chunks. Because that way it's more digestible for people instead of the big 4 hour monsters that we had before with the other ones. So we're going to take a break for a while. We'll probably be back later. Thanks for being here, everyone. If you're watching this on YouTube, do that a like and subscribe thing. And I will see you guys next time. Have a good night, everyone. Bye.